Good morning.
What are you doing here?
What do you think? Miss Sutton, what a pleasant surprise. May I join you?
Well, I was just
Thank
trying.
You. It's been a long time.
This is not the place. Later.
No.
May I help you?
Will Miss Sutton allow me to buy her a cup of coffee?
How can I possibly refuse? May I get you a menu?
No, that won't be necessary. How have you been, Miss Sutton?
Fine, and you?
Oh, splendid, all things considered.
Why are you doing this?
To remind you of your responsibilities.
I'm doing everything I'm supposed to be doing.
Not quickly enough.
Oh, always the one who's talking about risks. Why are you here?
Oh, to encourage the troops. And to remind you that stress is very bad for your father.
He's not under any stress.
He will be soon if this operation is delayed. I'm sure you wouldn't want to be responsible for another one of his attacks.
You're threatening me.
No, never. Your cooperation is very important to us. After all, we're family.
You never cared about Daddy or me.
Oh, that's where you're wrong, dear. I care a lot about you.
Don't call me dear. We're business affiliates. There's nothing endearing about it.
Oh, we're a lot more than business affiliates. We're cousins. And if you'd give me half a chance, we could be a lot closer cousins.
Stop it, Basil. Just stop it. We're here in Port Charles for one reason. You're always saying the plan comes first.
Everyone needs a little time to relax. Why don't you just let go for a minute?
I don't want anything from you.
Oh, actually, you do. You want money, and you want power. And so does your father.
Just leave my father out of this. You're always putting him down.
Actually, I have nothing against your father. It's just that he married my cousin. He doesn't belong in our family at all.
Neither do I, if it means being anything like you.
You enjoy success just like the rest of us. We're all in it for the money. And if you don't botch things up, there'll be plenty of it.
Some things are more important than money.
If you believe that, you don't belong in this family at all. Honestly, I think you're more talented than most of us. You just need more practice and a good coach.
If I needed a coach, I'd go to my father. Certainly not you.
Oh, suit yourself. But you may find yourself excommunicated if Reginald and Oliver get to hear what's been going on around here.
Reginald and Oliver have nothing to do with this.
Oh, Reginald and Oliver have everything to do with this. They could get rid of you just like that. Frankly, I've always thought you were the domestic type. They could set you up in a little estate outside London with the fresh air and the trees and the birds twittering. You could enjoy it all through the barred windows.
I'm tired of your threats.
Not threats, just reminders. Remember rule number 2 in the Sutton Bill of Rights is thou shalt get along with thy cousin. And I mean get along.
You know what you can do with your rules. You must try one of Kelly's famous homemade donuts. Hi, Luca. We were just talking about you.
Café?
No, I'm wired enough, thanks.
What's your problem?
What's my problem? I'm waiting for the phone to ring. They've had enough time to check out that shale.
What are you waiting for? We've got investors dying to get in. Why don't we start and open up the escrow account?
We're not going to do that until we're positive there's oil. We've talked about this a million times. It'll only take another day or so. Well, the oil is not going away.
No, but the Corsos might. They want an answer.
So do I, damn it. Come on, phone ring.
We need $500,000 for the Corsos. But then again, if this guy calls with a negative result from the shale test, we won't need any money.
Hey, relax, love. Look, if the Corsos are this interested, they'll wait a bit longer.
How can you be so sure?
They haven't stuck around this long unless they really want in on this deal.
Yeah, but it makes me nervous. They've got so many projects to choose from. They might get fed up and turn down us.
No, they won't.
How do you know?
I'm sure, because I'm psychic.
Well, I'm scared. I've never been this close to anything before, and I just don't want to blow it.
Robert, how do we convince this woman?
Your department, mate.
All right.
Now, come here and be convinced.
Not now, Luke.
That is all you ever say.
Yeah, I'm nervous about the telephone call.
The phone is going to ring. Trust me. Hey! What'd I tell you?
You got it.
Hello, Star.
And cross your fingers.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Well, you've got that look on your face. Yep.
It's, You got oil! You got oil!
Does that mean?
I told you! It means that we're gonna be rich!
It means... It means
millionaire.
It means millionaire. I always thought so.
I mean, lots of money. You know, like
the tycoons,
of money.
Uncle Scrooge, and all that.
Hey, let's
right.
call everybody. Let's spread the business, all right?
You're calling the Crusoes?
Oh, no. We can call him anytime. I'm going to call Sean Valley at the bank.
What are you doing?
What I'm doing? I'm going to do what you want me to do. I'm going to open the escrow account. We're going to put all the money into it that the investors want. And then when we drill the third hole and it hits, then we're going to transfer it all over to a corporate account. You want to make a list of all the people who want to invest? Oh!
This means good news.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, yeah, Sean Valley, please. Luke Spencer calling.
Everybody should get a personal call.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Jackie first. Tell her all systems are go.
Great. Oh, Mr. Valley, good news. We're ready to open the escrow account and accept investments. Oh, even the bank manager. Pretty happy about that, huh? Calm down. Yeah, we're glad, very, very glad that you're interested in investing. I think something can probably be done. Of course, there's a long list of people ahead of you. What's that? Oh, she's right here. He says congratulations. She said thank you. I said she said thank you. Yes, that's right. Okay, we'll be talking to you very soon. Madam President, you're requested to go to the bank. You have many papers to sign.
Is this for the escrow or the corporation?
This is for escrow. We open the escrow account, we put all the investors' money in it. After the third well hits, we transfer it to the corporate account for which we can both write checks.
That's when we pay the Corsos their $500,000.
All right, that's it. Let's go.
But, well, Luke, don't you think you should stay here and make those phone calls?
Wait a minute. She has a point here. I think the people should hear it from you first.
Yeah, especially before all the rumors start.
This is no rumor, baby. This is oil! We got oil!
Can't I handle the paperwork?
No. The escrow account demands two signatures, yours and mine, so that's it. No.
Aye, aye, sir.
All right, then, Robert Van Your Battle Stations.
I will.
We will celebrate later.
All right.
I'll need a personal bank.
Well, if you'll excuse me, I think I'll go lie down for a little while.
You're not ill?
No. I'm just tired.
Well, you take care of yourself.
That's what I'm doing. Excuse me, Mama, but tea.
Again. Well done.
Never do that again.
Never what? Compliment you?
Threaten me as you did this morning.
Oh, my dear, you do me an injustice. I never threaten beautiful young women. Just advise them.
Call it what you will, just never do it again.
My dear, I'll always remind you of the need for reality when I feel it's necessary. The need for diligence. In the past, your father wasn't as diligent as we might have hoped.
Just leave him out of this, will you?
No, we can't do that, can we? When he married your mother, he married into the family. For better or worse, he's one of us. Even when he lets us down.
And you've held it over his head ever since.
Oh, on the contrary, we've protected him. We've greased palms to keep him from languishing in Wormwood Scrubs prison. Had it not be for that, he wouldn't be enjoying the high life that we all work so hard to maintain.
He's very valuable to you.
Oh, to be sure. Yes, he certainly is. But we've kept perfect records of those transactions. One little slip and we could easily allow them out to the public.
He'd never survive prison, you know that.
Yes, I know. That's why we must succeed here. May I remind you of the enormous importance and the number of things that are hanging on our success on this particular operation, including and particularly your father's continued good health.
You'd never turn on him that way.
Of course not. Unless I had to.
Who's next?
Ah, did you get Slick and Emma?
Yes, Emma's great. She's going to buy a poodle and take Charlie to El Paso for Labor Day.
What about Slicka?
Start singing in Yiddish.
Well, look, you get that. I'll make the next few calls.
You call Jackie.
Ah, yeah, she's on her way. Where's Holly?
She's had an errand to run. Star! Yeah?
Hey, Captain, oh, Stunt's spreading the news.
It's oil, my boy.
Hi, Bert. You want to invest in an oil well?
That's great. I'll be able to say I knew you when. Now, I'm here, Luke, to investigate a murder.
Happy birthday, Star.
Robert, why don't you level with me and tell me what you fellas know about this Al Barker?
Well, nothing. We haven't already told you.
Come on.
Come up with something?
No, nothing so far. We know that it wasn't because of drugs that Barker was murdered. And so far, the only thing that we have found missing, we think, is his wallet. The guy carried very little cash. We have no motive, unless you two brilliant young men have some idea.
Gee, Bert, no. I'll get it. Well, this thing's going to drive me nuts.
And you know make that? You very wealthy.
Yeah, but you know, my throat's
I know, and the rash and all of that.
Why don't you get the phone?
Scratching and everything. Happy birthday, Star.
Look.
Look.
I wish you could help.
Well, I think I'll be able to use all the help I can get on this case, so here I stand without a motive. If you fellas just happen to remember something or some idea or a possible motive, why don't you just give me a ring? Huh?
We'll keep our ears open.
Good, thanks. Oh, by the way, congratulations.
Well,
I think.
Well, we're taking your name, but that's about all we can do at the moment. I have no pencil, I'm sorry. I'll just try to remember your number. 555-00. Okay, well, that'll probably work if I...
I tried to get through to you, but the phone's been impossible.
Yeah.
You know, the word's really spreading. Everybody in town's talking about it.
Sure.
Aren't you excited?
There's always a motive.
What are you talking about?
Al Barker got wasted for a reason. Luke, will you pull that bloody thing out of the wall and come over here?
Right. Look, I'll have to call you back. Hi, Jackie. What's the matter with you?
I don't know. I thought you'd be busting out the champagne.
Well, no, we haven't had time. Are you going to give out on making the calls?
Listen, we've got something important to do. We've got to figure out why Al Barker got killed.
Well, come on, man. That has nothing to do with us.
I'm not so sure. Now, listen. He contacts Jackie. He tests a piece of shale. Then he leaves a message on her tape machine. And the next move is he's dead.
The message could have been he wanted a date.
Oh, yeah? And he could also have been giving us some information.
So?
So, someone gets into Jackie's apartment and erases that message. Now, what does that tell you?
I don't like it.
I don't want to hear it.
This is leading somewhere.
Well, wherever it's leading, I don't want to go there.
All right, try this one. What if Barker discovered that there was no oil in that shale?
It doesn't fit. We had the shale tested at the university and there is oil in it.
All right, I've got another one for you. What if that is not the original piece of shale? What if somebody replaced it, like a person known replaced it?
That's crazy.
Maybe the lab just made a mistake.
A million things could have happened. It doesn't mean it has anything to do with us.
Come on, Luke, let's face it. I think it does. Look, what if someone's going to a whole lot of trouble to stop you finding out that that field is worthless?
Thing.
I didn't know you were there.
Well, Robert was saying it's crazy.
It's also possible.
Luke, what's he talking about?
We're reviewing the situation, that's all.
What situation? We went to the bank, we opened the account, we're ready for investors.
And something's wrong.
Why? The second test proved that there's oil on the land.
Yes, and the first guy that tested it happens to be dead.
His death has nothing to do with us.
We're beginning to wonder.
How do you know Barker even ran the test?
Babe, we don't know nothing. We're just supposing.
And supposing someone's trying to scare us off because there is oil there.
That really makes perfect sense.
That's right.
because then they could come in and go for the big profits. It's a typical Quartermain tactic.
Yeah, that makes more sense. Just don't say there's no oil.
Nobody said there wasn't any oil.
Why don't we go to another lab and have them run another test, a bigger lab?
That's a good idea.
What's the point? We've already got an answer.
Well, it wouldn't take very long. I could collect that sample from the university lab and have it expressed over to the National Institute for Oil Research.
No, why?
Why not?
What's the point? We've opened up the account.
Well, a day or so more won't hurt.
Oh, what's the point?
You're not thinking clearly.
This is ridiculous. I mean, what are people going to say when we say we've got to do another test on the land?
They're going to say, thank God those people are looking out for my interests.
Oh, we may turn them off. The investors might lose interest. Oh, I think we're just being amateurs.
We are amateurs. Oh, Polly.
Am I being crazy here?
No, just cautious. Another test makes perfect sense. I think Luke knows it.